Good morning, dear students. In this chapter, we will be studying midpoint theorem. This is a part of your quarterly syllabus. And I won't be giving you the proof of this theorem right now because from exam point of view, it is not necessary to study the proof. But in our normal classes, in our usual classes, once the school reopens, I will definitely be discussing the theorem proof. Prove how we are going to prove that this particular theorem which I am going to state is correct. Now, to solve the numerical problems, what you have to see is this. First of all, in this chapter, you will be seeing the midpoints. Suppose I have a triangle ABC and the midpoints are LM. Now, the theorem states that when these two midpoints are joined, that means LM will be parallel to the third side. That third side is the opposite side. And LM will be equal to half of this length also. Suppose this length is 7 cm, then the length of LM will be equal to half of 7 cm, that means 3.5 cm. So this is the meaning of midpoint theorem, and this is how we are going to apply. And the most important thing is that to apply this midpoint theorem, you should be having one of the two conditions. First is, either they will give you the midpoints of any of the two sides of the triangle, at least any of the two sides of the triangle, or they will say that we have a triangle in such a way that one line is running parallel to this and this side is equal to this side. Suppose they will say these two sides are parallel, one point. Second, they will say either of these two points, either these two sides are equal or these two sides are equal. Then only you can apply midpoint theorem. First condition that they will give you, either of these two, I am saying. First point they should give you that we have two midpoints of the triangle, and then calculate certain things, certain points, or prove this and that. Now, this is one condition they will provide, or they should provide that two lines are running parallel and this is the middle point and it is forming a triangle. So indirectly you are having here only one point, here you are having two points, parallel plus midpoint of any one of the sides. Then only you will be able to apply midpoint theorem, and then you all will be able to calculate the numerical problems. This is okay. Now one more thing, this midpoint is only applicable in case of triangle. If you have any square and they will say these two are midpoints, and they will say you prove that this side is equal to half or certain values and all those things. So this midpoint theorem you cannot apply. The only you can say is if this is half, this is half. Obviously this side will be equal to this side will be equal to this side. That obviously all of us know that. All of us know that midpoint means middle point of any of the line segments or any of the sections. So midpoint, if we have a rectangle or a trapezium for an example, if they give you midpoint and this line is joining, and then if you like to try to apply midpoint theorem, then you cannot say that this line will be parallel to this. You cannot say that this line will be parallel to this. You cannot say that this line will be half of this line. This also you cannot say. So the only thing that where you can apply this midpoint is in case of triangle. Whatever may be, whichever type of triangle may be it be a right angle triangle, be it be a isosceles triangle, be it be a escalene triangle, be it be an equilateral triangle. In all the types of triangle, you can apply this midpoint theorem, which states that this LM will be, this side will be parallel to this, and this will be half of this. Now, how you are going to solve a particular question? Suppose in a statement they have marked you, they have given you one triangle. They will say that ABC is such a triangle in which AB is equal to 5, suppose, and this is equal to 6 cm, and then we will have, they may give you like these two are the midpoints joining, then prove that this line is half of this, this line is parallel to this, and so on. So that very must, what you will do, how you can do, you can simply write, since it will be like LM example I am saying, you will say L is the midpoint, proof and all those things, you will write construction and all those things, if at all it is required, then you will write first that AL is equal to BL and AM is equal to MC, this point is given, therefore LM is parallel to BC and LM is equal to half of BC. And here you write from midpoint theorem. Only this much you have to do. Now, another type they may give, like this is a triangle and this side they will give suppose 7, and they will say that these two sides are equal and this line is parallel to this particular line ABCLN. This is another set of questions they may ask, like a triangle is there, one line LM is running parallel to this BC and this side is equal to this. Then they will ask you to find the value of this side. They will never ask you to find the value of these two sides. These two sides finding with this much of information is not possible. The only thing you can find is this opposite side, third side. So you will say LM is parallel to BC, and then you will say LM will be equal to half of BC. Therefore, BC will be equal to LM into 2, that is 7 into 2 is 14 centimeter. And here you will write from midpoint theorem, not MPT. Don't write MPT. Short form is not accepted in ICSE, okay? We cannot write, we should not write messaging information like MPT or CS, SSS and all those things, side angle side, that is another thing. But here you will write the full theorem name, midpoint theorem. Now, another thing they may ask you, like, if we have proved that this side is equal to this, in this particular question, they may ask one more thing, that find the value of BC by giving that much of information. Second, they will ask that prove that these two sides are equal. Then you will say, yes, by midpoint theorem, by converse of midpoint theorem, which I will discuss right now. By converse of midpoint theorem, we can say that these two lines, these two segments are equal in measurement. That I will discuss right now. So from this much point only, my dear students, there are only few numerical problems based on this. And in whichever book you will go and solve, try to see, be it be concise mathematics or ABD or APC or whatsoever, there are innumerable mathematics books. So I cannot state all those books right now. So what I was saying, that wherever you go, only this much two lines, this midpoint theorem is applicable in case of triangle. Two points are given, then you can apply. If these two conditions are given, then also you can apply. Then you all can calculate the values. So with this much idea, you all will be able to solve the midpoint theorem problems. Now I will be discussing converse of midpoint theorem. Converse of midpoint theorem. Converse of midpoint theorem. In this, what you will be having? You will be having like one triangle again, same thing. This thing will be marked, this line will be running parallel. This is L, this is M, this is B, C, A. Now, last problem that I discussed, it was a part of converse of midpoint theorem only. So they will say that LM is running parallel to BC, this side is equal to this side. Then they will ask, prove that this side is equal to this side. Now, very simple, you will say, since LM is parallel to BC and AL is equal to LB, given, therefore AM will be equal to MC by converse of midpoint theorem. By converse of midpoint theorem. So only one statement you have to use and then say, by converse of midpoint theorem, these two sides will be equal. Now, one more thing they may give you, like one triangle is there, right? Then they will give you the midpoints ABC. They will say that ABC is an equilateral triangle. ABC is an equilateral triangle. LMN, these are the midpoints. Then prove that this is also an equilateral triangle. First of all, ABC is what? ABC is equilateral triangle. Then you have to prove that LMN is also an equilateral triangle. So it is very easy. What you will do? MN is parallel to AB and MN will be half of AB. Second, you will write LN is parallel to AC and LN will be half of AC. Third, LM is parallel to BC and LM will be half of AC. So ultimately, at the last step, what you will get? LM is equal to half of, suppose I am writing log BC only, then MN is equal to half of AB, then you will write LN is equal to half of AC. Correct? Like this you will get after writing all those things, parallel and all those things. Then you will club all those things. After that you will write LM is equal to MN is equal to LN is equal to half of AB. Directly, since reason you will give AB is equal to BC is equal to AC, or you can write ABC is an equilateral triangle. If it is an equilateral triangle, half of all the sides will be equal. Suppose this side is 7, 7, 7. So half will be 3.5, 3.5, 3.5. You got the points? So in this way, you will prove that the given triangle is an equilateral triangle. One more thing, another triangle they may give, like one triangle will be there, ABC, such that this side AB is equal to AC, and then they will give you the midpoints of all the three sides, LMN, and then they will tell you to prove, ask you to prove that this LMN is an isosceles triangle. First of all, ABC is an isosceles triangle, that is given. Then you have to prove whether it is an isosceles triangle or not, and how it is isosceles triangle. So as you all can know, this side will be half of this. Half of this means half of AB you can write. Then this side will be half of AC. Half of AC, that means AC is equal to half of AC is equal to half of AC. AB is equal to half of AC you can write. Since AB is equal to AC, like this you can write. I hope you all can write. Now, since two sides are equal, third side if you want to calculate, you can calculate, or else you leave it. Now, in this much you can say this is an isosceles triangle. Now, if they ask you to prove whether this is an equilateral triangle or an isosceles triangle, and they will give you certain measurements. Suppose here they gave you 7, 7. Here also they will give you certain measurement, and then they will ask you to prove something else. Right. So, depending upon the situation and conditions, you all have to prove that. Now, one more thing, that they may give you one right angle triangle ABC, and they will also give you the middle point. Then they will say prove that this is 90 degree. Now, to prove that this is 90 degree, you have to apply Pythagoras theorem in between. Now, before that, you have to see which side is equal to half of what side, which side will be parallel, which side will be which angle will be equal to what angles. Like that, you have to apply all your brains, all your ideas and concepts, and then only you will be able to prove this. So the questions related to this chapter is a bit easy as compared to other proving chapters, other proving parts. Like we will be seeing another chapters in which we have to apply little bit more of logics, more of ideas and concepts. But in comparison to all those chapters, I think this is the easiest chapter in case of proving, that is proving the problems. Now, I will be discussing equal intercepts theorem. Equal intercepts theorem. Now, equal intercepts theorem means whenever we have three or more lines running parallel to each other, three or more lines, one line, second line, third line. These three are lines, there will be four line also, no problem. If they are running parallel like this, and we have one, this bisectors, or you say into this line, transversal, sorry, this is transversal, these lines are parallel to each other, then what is the meaning? The meaning, the statement says that if this side measurement is equal to this side measurement is equal to this side, so by equal intercept theorem, this side will also be equal to this side, this much only. Now, we will see this when we will go in proving part. Suppose I will draw one line like this and another line like this, and then from midpoint theorem, as you all can know, this side will be equal to this, this side will be equal to this, similarly, here also you will see this part will be equal to this part, and so on. Provings will be there. I don't want to name A, B, C, D and then prove right now. See, only I am here trying to give you the concepts and ideas, so that you all will be able to solve the numerical problems. Once you all will be able to solve the numerical problems, then when the school reopens, obviously I will be discussing how to prove this, though it is not required in our exam, though it is not required in our syllabus, sorry. So, but from exam point of view, though it is not required, but from knowledge point of view, it is definitely required, and I will be discussing in class how to prove this. Only this much part I am going to prove. And if you have any doubts regarding the numerical problems of this chapter or any other chapter, do please send me the pictures of those problems and mark the question number, so that I will make one video and then I will upload all those problems, so and then you all will be able to understand how that problem is being solved. As you all know that this is a class during lockdown, this is lockdown type class, so we cannot, I cannot teach you everything right now. Since I'm not in direct contact with you, I'm just a medium. This video is a medium to contact, is a contact between me and you. And I hope all of you must be able to understand the situation that all of us are facing. So try to cooperate with all the teachers, try to cooperate with me, and then try to study. Because ultimately it is you who have to face the exams, you have to face the challenges that is coming in future. So please do not waste your time. If my words really work, then please do study at your home without any excuses that saying that I don't have any books, I don't have this and that. You can arrange, now you all are grown up, my dear students, you all can arrange those books, pictures, and from wherever, there are so many sources, your friends are there nearby, your old books can be used, your friends can send you the pictures, they can tell you the theories and theorems and certain things. I know the book is not available, it was not available at that time, so we could not provide you all. And though it is not a responsibility of the schools to provide you the books, it is just a place where you all can get the books with less effort, that's all. The school does not have any connection with the books and all those things. They are just, they, we all have opened that center so that it will be easy for you to collect the books. And I don't want to speak more on that, or books and all those issues. So right now what I was discussing, equal intercept theorem. Now if I have another parallel lines, three lines, at least three should be there. If this measure 5, this measures 5, then if I have, so this will be equal to 4 and 4 also. It is not this, if it is 5, it is 5, this also be 5, no. If I have like this, then it may be like 6, 6. The slant is there, not slant line, this is a straight line. If I have like this, it may be 3, 3. So equal intercept theorem says that when we have three or more lines running parallel to it and the transversal is there, then that each and every section of this side will be equal to these equal sides. This side, if it is 7, 7, 7, no problem. This side, it may be 3, 3, 3 also. It may be 5, 5 also. Whatsoever may be the measurement, it is not necessary whatever measurement I have here, that same measurement will be here. That is not always true. That is not always true. This side, if it is 7, this side, it may be 5. It may be also equal to 7, no problem. It will be. It may have 8 also. It may be greater also. Because depending upon the slant of the line, the value, the measurements may keep on changing. So the only concept, the only idea that we have right now based on this, that we all should, you all should have in your brain, that this much section in equal intercept theorem is applicable, then this line will be equal to this line, this much segment, this segment, and this corresponding segment will be different in measurements, equal in measurements but different to this side. It's not always, it is not always that they all will be equal. Now based on this, they may again ask you, like we have certain lines, three lines are there, and then they will ask you, this triangle is there, prove that this side is equal to half of this, this side measurement, that and all those things. There are only 3 to 4 problems, and that also is very easy. I remember last year I was teaching that the same book, and the number of problems in this particular chapter as well as in this particular exercise is very, very less. It's very, very less. If you really want to study, if you really want to understand more in a better way, then you can follow the other textbooks, other textbook as a reference, so that you will get a vast knowledge based on this chapter. And the problem that it is given in your book is very simple and easy. If you want, you can just turn the pages and see whatever I am saying is true or wrong, true or false.
I hope it will be clear. So this much idea is necessary for your proving part, and I think you all will be able to solve. Thank you.